From family events, to volunteer opportunities, to community happenings, there is a lot going on in your community. Learn about all the possibilities and opportunities on this episode of Community Hotline.
Welcome to Community Hotline. My name is Monica Weitzel. We're here at MetroEast Community Media in Gresham, Oregon. And with me today, my first guest is from the American Red Cross, specifically the Blood Services Region. Welcome, Daphne Matthew.
Thank you so much, Monica.
It's nice to have you here. Daphne, you are the Communications Manager.
Yes.
And that's for the American Red Cross Blood Services Region. Mm-hmm. What region is that? What area does that cover?
That's Oregon and Washington. We go all the way up into Longview and the Centralia Chehalis area down to Medford, all the way over to Klamath Falls, and all the way up to Yakima.
Oh, wow.
So a huge territory.
That is a large territory. Yeah. Now, most everybody knows the American Red Cross. You've been around for, I don't know, how long is it? How long? Do you have any idea?
130 some years.
That's a little before my time. So everybody knows the American Red Cross, but you do a lot that probably not everybody knows about. So can you just give me a little brief synopsis of what all the Red Cross does?
Sure. What I'm directly involved with is blood services. Mm-hmm. So we collect blood, we collect platelets, we collect plasma, and all these things go to help cancer patients, people who are suffering from trauma or, you know, premature babies. Mm-hmm. So we have the opportunity to help the general public through the generosity of donors. And then we also help in times of disaster. A good example is Hurricane Sandy.
Right.
And we're at the ready all the time to get out there and help people who are in need. We also do service to armed forces, which a lot of people aren't aware what we do.
Now tell me about that.
It's a communication program. And so if a soldier has something happen in their family, maybe it's a birth of a baby, a loss of a loved one.
It can be good or bad.
Good or bad, we communicate that information to them and then assist them in any way that we can.
Really?
So it's a really nice connection for our military. And then we also have international services. So we work with all different countries and make sure that the American Red Cross is there representing neutrality, humanitarianism, and helping people in need.
That was a very good explanation. So you specifically then work with the blood services. Tell me what your job entails. What do you do? I mean, I know you're the communication, so you're probably the voice and the face of that branch of your organization. But what do they do in that department?
Well, you know, I'm a department of one.
Oh, okay.
So it's just me. But what I do is internal and external communication. Mm-hmm. So, you know, working with our internal group, with our employees and our volunteers, and getting the word out to them for whatever they need to be educated about, or it could be fun stuff, it could be something that's happening in our community.
Right.
And then I also work with media. So, you know, sending out press releases and then responding to media who have inquiries. And some speaking engagements and going out into the community and telling people how valuable it is to donate blood and platelets.
So why don't you tell our viewers why it's important? And I'll tell you, in my viewpoint, not everybody can afford to donate money to charities, but not everybody can, but the high percentage of people can afford to donate blood. I mean, you know, that's such an easy thing to do. If I don't have money to give to an organization, I know I can always go and give blood, and I'll feel good about doing something to perhaps save somebody's life.
Yeah.
And I think there's a lot of people that don't consider doing it when it's really, really so easy, and you make it easy. So tell us a little bit about the process of donating blood and why it's important.
It's important because it helps save lives. So one unit can help save up to three lives because we take the blood and separate it into different components.
Okay.
And then in addition to that, there's platelet donation that's really directly involved with cancer patients.
Right.
And so anytime that you help someone, it's an important thing to do. The process is, whether you're donating blood or platelets, mm-hmm. you come in and we have you read over some information to make sure that you're eligible to donate that day. And if a person feels like they may be eligible to donate after reading that material, then they go into a health history time where right. we ask about 50 some questions. So it's an in-depth history right. background. Right. Then we do a mini physical. So blood pressure, temperature, check your iron to make sure right. you have enough iron in your blood to help others. And then we move you on to the donation process. And that's probably the shortest part of the whole thing.
Yeah,
you know, we
yeah,
cleanse the arm, make sure mm-hmm. that it's all nice and clean and very prescribed in the way that we do things.
Yes.
And then we just do the needle stick. That's probably the part that people worry the most about. Is the needle
so
stick.
Good. I don't think I've ever had anyone that hurt me giving me a needle stick. I mean, they're quick, they're uh-huh. it's painless.
The phlebotomists do that every day.
Yeah, they're professionals.
They absolutely know what they're doing. Yeah. And sure, sometimes, you know, something may go wrong, but for the most part, it's really a great experience. It takes about 7 to 10 minutes to actually donate the blood.
It's amazing how fast.
Yeah.
How fast you can.
And then you're off
capture.
To juice and cookies.
That's right.
So,
that's my favorite.
You know,
part.
That's the reward.
So, about how long would you say it takes for the whole process, from going into the, you know, your assessment, your health evaluation, and all that? Maybe
about an hour.
About an hour. Okay.
We ask people to expect an hour, and in times when we have, you know, the public coming out, say for instance, during Hurricane Sandy, mm-hmm. we had a lot of people responding, and we had right. some public officials who appealed to the public to come out and donate blood. So, you know, we had a lot of people
longer
just
lines,
showing
probably.
Up, longer mm-hmm. lines, but, you know, we really found that people were understanding and willing to wait to be able to help.
There's a lot of camaraderie when people are
sure.
all there trying to help their fellow man, you know, for the same reason. And I think, you know, every time I've given blood, everybody talks to each other when you're waiting in line, and you know, it's just, you know, you're doing something that's good.
And you're all like-minded in
yes,
what you're doing.
Yes.
So there's a camaraderie there.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Now the platelets, mm-hmm. I've done that before too, and that takes a little bit longer. Mm-hmm. But you've refined the process a lot from the first time that I ever took it, because it used to be like a 2-hour. Procedure, but I don't think it takes
well,
that
we used
long,
to,
does it?
One of the things that we refined, and in fact, I started my career at the American Red Cross in the apheresis department
okay.
with people who donated platelets, and I was the donor development manager, so bringing new people into the program. And what we do is, there's a machine that sits by you, which mm-hmm. you well mm-hmm. know. It used to be that we used both arms.
Right.
So a donor would literally mm-hmm. have needles in both arms, which yes. is really heroic, you know, to sit there for an hour and a half
they
or
gave
2 hours.
Movies to watch, and it was just enough
yeah.
time to watch a movie.
It's exactly right. And that's it's still about the time frame now, but we're down to a single arm donation.
Mm, right.
You know, we have so many people who want to use their iPad or, you know,
yeah.
believe it or not, some people are working
oh,
while they're donating.
I mean,
but
that's a break for me.
Yeah. So you get to put your feet up, you get a blanket, you know, you get a heating pad, stay nice and cozy. Mm-hmm. And during that process, what we're doing is separating the platelets out of your blood and keeping that for patients who are in need. And what platelets do is they help clot the blood. So that's really important for people who are going through chemotherapy, because many times they're not able to clot their own blood.
Mm-hmm.
So even giving them transfusions would do no good, because it would just go right through them without the clotting capability.
I may be wrong about this, but correct me if I am, but it seems to me I remember being called to do a platelet donation when there was somebody who was going to have maybe a kidney transplant or something like that, because I had some rare antigens in my blood, mm-hmm. so they wanted to transfuse them. Would that be possible, or am I mixing that up with the cell panel thing that I
Well,
that
it
I
sounds
did.
To me like you were a directed donor, so it may have been someone specific in the hospital mm-hmm. that...
Yes, it was somebody specific, yes.
Isn't that a
yeah.
great feeling?
Yeah, yeah.
And so
like,
it's
wow.
a HLA, human leukocyte antigen,
okay.
that matched that person or was a close match to that person, so they called you in specifically to come in and donate,
okay.
and that unit most likely went out to that person
okay.
in the hospital.
Yeah, that's what I remember, and I think I'll remember that happening once, but it's a really great feeling to be
it
able
is.
To do that.
Yeah.
Now you have a couple blood drives coming up.
We do.
So, yes. Now one of them is called the Galaxy Blood Drive. What exactly does that refer to?
Well, we want blood donation to be fun. You know, it's not always just coming in to give blood. We do a lot of special events, but
okay.
this one is really unique and kind of quirky, which
I like
is
quirky.
Fun.
I like quirky.
And it's Star Wars versus Star Trek. So all, you know, all these fans, the Klingons and the Chewbacca and stormtroopers, oh, all of them. You know, there's big fan bases on both sides.
Yes, there are.
And so we thought, well, they're out in the community doing things for good, and we met with them and said, how about a blood drive? And they're all bought into it, and they come in their movie grade costumes.
Oh, that's great.
And there's families there, and the kids are just so intrigued, and the adults are intrigued.
Yeah.
You know, getting to meet these people, we take pictures, and they're donating blood, and so it's just a really great thing. It's Wednesday, December 29th, from about 9 until 2:30 in the afternoon.
That's great. Right after Christmas,
yeah.
You know, things are slowing down.
Right.
What a neat thing to be able to take your kids to see what you're doing, giving mm-hmm. blood, because kids usually aren't tagging along for something like that, but to
right.
be able to see what you're doing and to explain to them how they're, you know, this is helping save a life, so that as they grow up, you know, when they're, what, you have to be 18, I think, and
16 with 16. Parental consent.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Once they're 17, they can do it on their own.
Okay. So, yeah.
I
mean, I think that's great. So do you get the, you know, the Chewbaccas and the stormtroopers and everybody out there giving blood too? Do some of them do that too?
With the Chewbacca, we couldn't actually do the arm scrub and the stick, so he would have to take his outfit off. So that happens.
It wouldn't be the same, would it? Yeah.
Yeah, but there are the, you know, figures.
You know, Princess Leia or somebody.
Yeah. Oh yeah, Princess Leia, and there's one gal who comes in all blue, and it's just really beautiful.
That's great.
Yeah.
That sounds like fun.
Yeah, it is.
So you do have events fairly frequently. I mean, uh-huh. What other kinds of things do you do? I mean, do you do this to raise awareness? As a draw to get people in to donate blood or?
We want to celebrate special holidays, but the reason why we do events like this is because the need for blood is constant.
Mm-hmm.
So even though, you know, we talked about Storm Sandy, Superstorm Sandy,
yeah.
blood donors coming out, and, you know, they came out in more of an episodic fashion where they're responding to that immediate
right.
need.
Right.
But what we want to really bring across to people is that you can donate up to 6 times a year.
Yeah.
And you can donate platelets up to 24 times a year. So we'd like to see these donors who are coming out in, you know, response to that, to understand that there's patients consistently behind the need for blood and platelets.
Right.
And so I absolutely forgot what your original question was, but
events. Are you trying to draw people? So you're
Thanksgiving, we do a Thanksgiving drive with pumpkin pie and t-shirts. We do 4th of July. We did a huge Civil War blood drive, Ducks Against the Beavers.
Yes, I did that one. Yeah.
That has 11-year history to it. And this year we collected more blood and had more votes than we have in any other campaign in the 11-year history.
That's
so
great.
It was
a big one. So people go and they donate blood and they get to vote on who they're mm-hmm. donating blood in honor of in the name of the Oregon State Beavers the U of O Ducks.
It's a huge rivalry, of course, just in the game itself, but then the blood drive has taken on a life of its own.
That's great.
Yeah.
That's what a great way to, you know, to make it more fun.
Uh-huh.
So you have something else coming up that I was reading about called the Battle of the Badges.
Yes.
That I've never heard about. What is that?
Well, you know, we're modeling after a Southern California region who's been very successful with public safety in firefighters, mm-hmm. and then law enforcement and police. And
like the fireman's badge and the policeman's badge.
Exactly. And then we have those two forces come mm-hmm. together and do a little battle of their own. So battle of the badges.
So how much blood they can...
Yeah, whoever can collect the most for each, you know, representative team.
So is it the firefighters and policemen themselves or people who also donate in their name?
Like, yeah, they would come in and fill out a ballot,
okay,
and then
vote. So I'm doing
vote.
It for the firemen, I'm doing it for the policemen.
Right, exactly.
Oh, cool.
And what we're doing right now is engaging agencies. And so if agencies haven't heard about it yet, you know, we encourage them to call.
And by agencies, you mean like what? Like
Gresham Fire, Gresham Police,
You
know,
yeah.
Portland Police, Portland Fire.
Right.
Yeah,
okay.
And get
okay.
engaged in the Battle of the Badges.
Fun. Now that is going to be here in Portland, is that right?
It's in Portland metropolitan area for
so
the most part.
So even just wherever you are, there'll be,
yeah.
you can donate wherever.
Uh-huh. And it's a month long.
Oh.
It's going to be January 16th through February 16th.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Perfect. You'll finish up right after Valentine's Day.
Exactly.
Yeah. I wanted to ask a question going back
sure.
to the platelets. Can the platelets be donated anywhere besides your main center, or is that the only place that you do that kind of donation?
We have three sites.
Okay, where are those?
So platelets aren't really extremely mobile. It
right,
has to be
right.
A big
That's,
site.
Yeah, I know you can't take your little your blood mobile out there and do
right.
that.
Right. So we have three locations, and one in Portland mm-hmm. at 3131 North Vancouver Avenue, right by Legacy Emmanuel.
Right.
And then we have a Vancouver site to, you know, for people who live in Southwest Washington so they don't have to come over the bridge.
Right.
And that's
traffic.
Right at the, exactly, at the Vancouver Mall.
Oh,
and it's
okay.
on the Macy's side of the mall.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that.
Yeah. And then we have one in Richland, Washington.
Right. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that's good. Good.
So we have Tri-Cities working up there for gathering platelets. Yeah,
eventually you'll probably have one down in Southern Oregon too.
Yeah, Southern Oregon or Bend would be,
Bend would be
a
great.
Really
yeah,
great location.
That would be good. So tell me, I'm sure in the time that you've worked there that you've heard lots of great heartwarming stories. Yeah. Share something with me. Tell me something that has meant something to you as far as people that have been helped.
Well, I have a story of my own, an experience that I had.
Okay, that's even better.
Yeah, I was in Texas, and I was at a convention that had nothing to do with the American Red Cross, mm-hmm. but it ended up that Red Cross was all around me, and so I was going to the airport, mm-hmm. got on the shuttle, and there was a man in front of me, and he just said, good morning, that was it.
Mm-hmm.
And then two other ladies got on the bus, and so there's, you know, the four of us and the bus driver, and all the way to the airport, we talked about, you know, what we do outside of that convention.
Uh-huh.
And it happened to be that I told her I worked for the American Red Cross and recruited platelet donors. And she said, oh, I'm a platelet donor. And so that just in itself was unique because
there's
less than 2% of the people donate platelets.
Really?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And so the man was still silent. And so we talked all the way about how great it is to save lives and help people out. And then he was getting off to go to his plane. And he turned around and said, I guess I should thank both of you ladies because I'm a bone marrow transplant recipient. And without people like you, I wouldn't be alive today.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
So I thought, that's why I work for the Red Cross.
Yeah.
You know?
How cool. Doesn't that make you feel great? Oh.
Yeah. It gives me a shiver.
He probably couldn't even say anything before he had to get off because he probably would have broken down crying. Mm-hmm. I would have.
Yeah.
Wow.
So it was such a genuine conversation between the two of us, and not knowing what I saw was the cycle of life, the circle of life unfolding right in front of my eyes, from recruiter to donor to recipient, all in that little bus.
That's beautiful.
It was the greatest
thing. That's beautiful.
Yeah.
We're almost out of time, so tell me what else we should know about the American Red Cross that maybe we haven't talked about.
Well, one thing that we want people to know is, you know, enjoy your holidays, have a great time with your family and friends, but make that donation appointment to come in at the first part of the year. We've already talked about the need is constant.
Mm-hmm.
So one thing we do like people to do is make an appointment. And the way that you can do that is to call 1-800-RED-CROSS. There'll be an operator that can help you out and schedule a time that's convenient, a convenient place and convenient time for you. Or you can log onto the website and then schedule your own appointment based on what looks good for you.
Yeah, and that's what I do now. I just look and it's like,
zip
okay,
code.
I can do this, I can do that. Yeah, it makes it real easy.
It does.
Sometimes I do it on my lunch hour at work. Sometimes I do it after work. Yeah, it works out great. Good. Well, thank you so much, Daphne.
Oh, you're very welcome. Yeah, it's been a pleasure.
Eliminated our viewers on you know, it's a simple thing to do, and I hope that we'll encourage more people to get out there and donate blood. So thanks
thank
so
you.
Much. Don't go away. We'll be right back. We'll be talking with the Metro Toy Drive.